made law the executive authority of the state in those matters and financial arrangements between the federal government and the state, special treatment of native of the state. So this all is included in the Sabah or Sarawak or both Sabah and Sarawak, this matter. First, citizenship of person born before Malaysia Day. The second, the constitutional adjudication of the High Court Borneo. The third is the matter with respect to which delegation of the state may or may not make law, the executive authority of the state in those matter and financial arrangement between the federal government and the state, and special treatment of native of the state. Okay, this is the second amends that is needs the consent of Yang di-Pertuan Negeri Sabah or Sarawak or both. Okay, and then the third one, the third one amends is some article may amend by the two-third majority in each house of parliament, and these amends do not require the consent of anybody. That means that doesn't need Yang di-Pertuan Agong, or doesn't need Malay Council of Rural, or doesn't need Yang di-Pertuan Negeri or Sabah Sarawak or both too. This amendment is a waste, is a, we call it peruntukan kewangan or the bills. Okay. And then the last one amendment is some articles are not the most but may be amended by the simple majority of both Senate and the House of Representatives in Parliament. Okay. Yang kategori keempat ini, yang the kategori empat ini, this amendment, I give you the examples, is a budget. Budget. So budget need a simple majority only. No need two-third of majority. Okay. And then we go into the last is the futures. Okay, I say that just now already told to you. Okay, the source of law, Islamic law, custom law, we call it the common law, and then we call it jurisdictions. And then British Americans, and then another one is we must know that Islamic law. Okay, so there's a five of the source of law. Okay, and then we go into this. We have Malaysia, features of Malaysia federalism in the constitutions. F2, what is the state? What is the federal governments? And then the third one must know that is the local governments. So the in our constitutions, in our conditions, have given the power according to the state list, federal list, continent list. So federal list is the federal power over the state. State list is the state power. And the third one, concurrent list, is almost for Sabah and Sarawak and local government's power. Local government's power. So this local government's power sometimes included state and federal. So we have three risks: federal risk, state risk, and concurrent risk. And Malaysia Constitution also have a 13 schedule. 13 schedule. Okay. And then you must know that our constitutional have also a guideline how the relationship between the state, federal, local government, how the relationship between the federal with the Malaysians, state with the his people in the state. And then also in our constitutions have already outlined the territorial governments. That means that territorial governments maksudnya kamu kena faham sepadan kuasa negeri, sepadan kuasa daerah dalam kerajaan tempatan ataupun dipanggil sebagai local government. So they have a right and power between within the territorial governments. Maksudnya kerajaan negeri Kelantan hanya ada kuasa dalam negeri Kelantan. Dan contohnya Majlis Kota Baru MPKBI, MPKBI, Majlis Pembendaharaan Kota Baru Bandaraya Islam ni hanya mempunyai kuasa ke atas sepadan kuasa di bawah Kota Baru. Macang ada kuasa di bawah Macang. Okey. Game you nak? Okey. Okay, nak? So you must understand, me understand, we must understand also, you must understand the chronology of Malaysia federalisms. Malaysia federalisms, Federal Agreements 1895. See that? Malayan Union 1946. And then we have a fully written law on Federation of Malaya 1948. Federations of Malaysia 1963 and one thing Federations of Malaya 1957. So that means that this is we call it the constitutional law. The constitutional law, one of the source is the from the past is the British Emirations. From the Federal Agreements to Malaya Union and then to Federation of Malaya, Federation of 1948, Malaya Malaya, Federation of Malaya 1957 dan Federation of Malaysia. Maksudnya di sini kamu kena faham kronologi persekutuan Malaysia ini adalah salah satu sumber undang-undang. Okey, salah satu undang-undang. So sebelum 1948, semua perundangan ini dipanggil sebagai British Emulation. British Emulation Law adalah salah satu sumber tidak rasmi. Cuma kita ada yang rasmi dan bertulis 1948 Persekutuan Tanah Melayu 1948 dan Persekutuan Tanah Melayu 1997 dan akhir sekali Persekutuan Malaysia 1963. So, we end of the chapter 5. Thank you. Assalamualaikum.